dear colleagues, as the European United Left, we believe that growth indicators, positive or recessionary, do not reflect the real situation the majority of the people are facing in a given society, namely the situation of working people, households, the self-employed, and small businesses. These indicators do not reveal how much public wealth is being privatized and how much salaries and working people rights are being kept in order to get the economy moving. My country, Cyprus, is a prime example. On the one hand, the government is celebrating improved indicators on growth and the country's formal exit from the memorandum. On the other hand, according to the Gini coefficient, over the past 4 years, Cypriot people have suffered the biggest increase in social inequalities in Europe. Cyprus also registers the worst performance in Europe with regard to public spending on health and social benefits. Wages have fallen to 1996 levels, while unemployment remains amongst the highest in Europe, and the young generation has been forced to migrate out of the country. This is why we believe we should look beyond indicators, or at least attach equal importance to other indicators. In this sense, the report's alarming key point on the continuing trend of widening inequalities even after the crisis must be underlined. Indeed, as the report points out, and as Mr. Gurria just before explained to us, sharpening inequalities in addition to the severe humanitarian costs also undermines growth in economic terms. The key question is what we should do. Despite the different and opposing views on this issue, we believe that the report includes certain recommendations that can be broadly supported, that is, inter alia, public investment in green economy, strengthening labor laws, increasing the efficiency of public spending, combating tax evasion of big enterprises, ensuring equality of results in education, implementation of social measures to support the family. Bearing this in mind, we as the left at the EU level also support that social indicators, such as, for example, dignified work and child poverty, be included and made binding in the European semester process, where member states are monitored for their economic and financial policy. As the report we have before us also confirms, by supporting the welfare state and combating inequality, unemployment, and poverty, we are in fact creating the preconditions for real growth. Not simply growth in economic and financial terms, but growth with the right content that will take into account, first and above all, people and their needs. Thank you very much.